Kelly.
Clayton, we've got to talk.
All right. You have to come all the way up here just to talk?
It's more private here.
How do you like my new office?
It's nice. Clayton, I've been waiting for you to tell me about something. And you haven't. I've given you every chance, and you've said nothing.
What are you talking about? Ellie, why don't you sit down?
Oh, damn it, Clayton. Damn it! Who is she?
Who?
Oh, don't play games! Her!
She's a girl in a painting.
Who is she?
She's a model, I suppose.
And?
And? Nothing.
I saw you with her in a restaurant. I saw her kiss you. I saw you leave this building together. The building that you wouldn't let me visit.
Ellie was all so innocent.
If it was so innocent, why didn't you tell me about it?
I didn't think you'd understand. It was just a friendship. A man's allowed to have friends.
Not that kind of friend.
Nothing happened, Ellie.
Are you trying to tell me? Are you trying to tell me you didn't go to bed with her?
That's right.
But you wanted to.
It was nothing like that.
Then why? Why have you been seeing her?
She made me feel like a man again. Everybody else would treat me like a damned invalid, most of all you.
Oh, don't you try to lay your guilt on me.
I don't feel guilty.
Well, I find that very remarkable.
Ellie, try to understand. I wasn't getting something that I needed. Call it my male ego or the fear of growing old or whatever happens to a man my age.
What about me? What about me? What am I supposed to do when you chase your lost youth? I'm getting older. And I have an ego. Oh. Oh, Clayton. I trusted you.
Well, nothing's changed. The way I feel about you hasn't changed.
What's changed is how I feel about you. I can't live with a man who I can't trust anymore.
Ellie, it's all over between the girl and me.
It's too late. Don't you see? Don't you see what you've done to me?
Let's go home and talk about this.
You go home and get your things. I want you out.